For these two Forstner drills, I paid the same money as for a complete set of 15 drills from 10 to 50 millimeters. Today, we will sharpen one of these cheap drills to perform as well as the expensive ones. The cheap drill is not cutting very well. It is creating dust, but not chips. The more expensive one, in contrast, is creating curly shavings. Let me show you how to sharpen a drill with this jig and then show you how to build the jig yourself. Let's put the drill in the jig and tighten it. We will first sharpen the outer rim. After removing the lock pin from the jig, the chuck is locked in place and we can tighten it to hold the drill bit in place. For the outer rim, we use either a cheap diamond or an abrasive grinder with a cylindrical shape. The grinder is put in the drill press. We put the lock pin back in the jig so that the chuck can rotate freely. After loosening the knobs on the sides, we adjust the angle so that the edge of the outer rim is in full contact with the grinder. As a quick test, you can color the edge with a Sharpie and control that at least the upper half of the coloring is removed. Next, we push the base very much to the front of the track and fix the plywood base to the drill press with a clamp so that the edge is just touching the grinder. After starting the drill at slow speed, we can carefully grind the cutting edge. With the same setup, we can touch up the tip of the drill bit. Let's remove the lock pin, loosen the chuck, then adjust the tip so that the side of the tip is parallel to the edge of the jig, and then tighten the chuck again. Again, the angle is adjusted so that the entire side of the tip is touching the grinder. When locking the plywood to the table, the tip should only lightly touch the grinder. Now we move the jig forward within the tracks and grind the first side. After the first side is refreshed, we move the jig back, turn the drill 90 degrees and continue with the next side. The last edge we have to grind is the inner cutter. For the inner cutter, we have to switch from the cylindrical grinder to a grinding or a diamond disc. Fix the grinder in the drill press and then put the jig on the drill press table. The lock pin is not in the jig and the cutting edge is aligned parallel to the front side of the jig. The angle is adjusted so that the entire cutting edge touches the disc. Move the jig forward to grind one edge. Stabilize the jig with your hand by moving it forward. Then move it back, turn the drill 180 degrees and grind the other side. The freshly sharpened drill performs really well. It creates chips and drills super fast. Let's now have a look how to build this jig. All the STL files and a very detailed assembly instruction will be for sale on my website. The first thing to assemble is the chuck. Here we have two options. Either a fully 3D printed chuck or an adapter for this cheap Chinese quick release chuck. For the quick release chuck, we just print the adapter and press fit it to the chuck. When you are sure that it works, it is a good idea to secure the chuck with a drop of glue. For the 3D printed chuck, we need to pick the right diameter of the Forstner bit shaft. I created versions for the chuck in 0.5 mm increments. Just pick the right one that corresponds to the diameter of your Forstner bits. The shaft of my set is 9.5 mm and the 3D printed version works for the entire set. Next are the knobs. For the larger knobs, we press fit an M8 nut into one part. The other part gets a 100 mm long M8 machine screw tapped in place. The square base holder is secured with a 70 mm long M6 screw to the track base. The next step is optional and not strictly necessary. When grinding several drills in a row, I found it more convenient to mark the right position and lock the base in a certain place rather than clamping down the entire base. For this feature, we install an eccentric lever with a 50 mm M6 machine screw. When pushing the lever forward, the base is locked securely in place. After connecting the two M8 knobs through the base, we can lock it at a certain angle. The first track is positioned on the plywood and aligned parallel to the border. The holes are pre-drilled and then secured with screws. With a paper shim, the track and the base on the other side is screwed in place. After removing the shim, the base should slide freely between the two tracks. The last thing is to assemble the lock pin. Gluing the two parts of the cap together is only for the look, and with that the jig is finished. I sharpen now all my Forstner bits with this jig and it performs really well. The drill works fine, and in contrast to a complete expensive set for 300 euros, I can resharpen these drills whenever they get dull again. I will leave a link to the plan and the STL files in the description.